Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. My name is Sam and I'm a business intelligence developer. Well, I was working with the Indian financial data and I have particularly found about that the data is lying over in the internet. I cannot reveal the source because I had to use my username and password. So finally, I have actually managed the data into five different categories. If you go to the inner depth of it, you can see that the data is in investments, current payment, India's loan, payment stream, and total loans that can India can pay. So let's just begin with it using the Power BI. So I have the Power BI and I have this particular model set in front of me. And once I'm here, I can use the get data and I can use the Excel sheet. And if I take my data loading over here, so I'll take one at a time. So I'll take the India's investment. And if I just click it open, the data will get connected and it will ask me whether I should load it or not, which I will not. So I will use the edit. And once it goes to edit, it goes to the Power Query window. Now, once I'm in Power Query window, you can see that the data is pretty much very in rough condition and I need to polish it. I need to clean it. I need to mend it before loading up into the Power BI or Power Query engine. So first is the date column, which I definitely want to remove into the date, and it's asking me the change column type. So I will use add a new step. Once I do it, it is giving me the particular dates. I definitely need the loan number, but I do not need the region. I do not need the country code. I do not need the country. I do not need the borrower. I do not need the guarantor code, any guarantor, but I need the loan type and the loan status. Now, once I am here, I have the interest rate. This interest rate, I need to be converted into whole number. So I will simply go to my transform and here I will multiply it with 100. Once I'm in here, I will simply press on OK and it comes to this thing and simply I will click on change type. I will convert into the whole number. So once it is done in this factor, I'll go to the currency of commitment. I do not need it. Similarly, the project ID, I have already the IBRD. I do not need it. The project name, definitely I need it. The original principal amount, again, I need to convert it into, I will divide it by 100 and then I will convert it into the whole number. So I will simply divide this column with 100 or even I can make 1000. So once I do it, I have this short of the digits and the numbers and I will simply convert this into the whole number. Similarly, I will be working on with the cancelled amount and in here I have no such interest for the cancelled amount, so I will simply remove this column. Undisbursed amount, I'll again divide by 100 and once I do it, it will simply give me this. And notice it is a decimal number, so I need to round up. And if I'm rounding up, I need to round up into this particular number. Now once I do it, I have to check whether it is in a whole number or not, and it is giving me the particular whole number. So like that it flows, and this is also basically the decimal number. So I will round down. Once I do it, it comes into this. And now I will divide this by 100. And once I do it, it will give me the same thing again. I agree. But this time I will go for the rounding up again. And once I do, I can clean the data into particular part. Notice this is already been converted into a whole number. For checking, I can check if it's giving the whole number here. The repaid to IBRD, I will simply again divide this by 100. And once I do, I have this particular number and I can say that I need to change into the I need to change into the I need to change into the whole number. And the due to IBRD, the same thing, I will divide it by 100. And once I do, it will give me this. And I will, this time I will make it up a rounding up the number. And once I rounding it up, it will give me this particular column. And with this column, I can check it is a whole number or not. And if it is showing up, what I will do, I will simply delete this column, which is my due to IBRD. I will delete this column and I can reshift it into my next agenda. And similarly, I will exchange the adjustment and I'll take all this column until the end, and I will remove this column and I will write it here that due to IBRD. This is one of the beauty part of the Power Query. And if I check upon the advanced editor, it can give me all certain type of the columns whichever I needed for to change the amount. Now I need to change the table name. So what I'll put table name, I will use is that investments for the best of my knowledge and conscience. And like that, I will make the other columns as well. So if you want to be with me, if you want to look upon with this, please, you are all welcome. Otherwise, that is the end of this video. And for the next part, I will use the DAX measures as well as other calculations or aggregations method that can bring out the financial sector's problem with the India. Also, in this video, I will use the relationship methods if you want to look up into. So what I'll do is I will take the Excel sheet again and I will use the current payment. And in this current payment, I will use the same methodology again. So I will split it into the date and I'll add a new step. The loan number is, I wanted region, country code, country, borrower, guarantee and guarantor. I don't need it at all. I do not need the loan pool. I need the loan status, definitely. Interest rate, I will round up into, or I will make it into the whole number. Simultaneously, I'll delete the currency of commitment, project ID, project name, I need it. The principal amount, I will divide it amount by 100. So once I do it, I can get it up short like this. And it's already a whole number. Cancelled amount, I have no such interest for it. Undisbursed amount, I have no such interest for it. Hold on, I need the cancelled amount. Yes, of course, because that is the reason for which the loan need to be checked it upon. So what I'll do is I will multiply it by 100. Insert a step, of course, insert a step, and I will 100, I'll multiply it and I'll say get it like this. And this time what I will do is I will divide it by 1000. And once I do it, I can get the shot like this. And similarly, I will round it out down. And once I do it, I can get the values like this. Notice it has already been changed into the whole number. Similarly, undisbursed amount, I do not need at all. And as well as the disbursed amount, this time I will divide by 1000. So once I do it, I'll get the numbers like this. And it is in the decimal number, so I will round it up down. So it will give me the perfect whole number for which I am looking out for. Repaid to IBRD. Similarly, I will divide this by 1000, and once I will do it, I can make it up into like this, and I will rounding up down, and it's giving me the particular whole number. Now, all these columns which are present over here, I will delete this particular column, and it will give me the correct data, and I have this particular data. So India's current problem it is showing me an error in here. So if I can, okay, my phone undisbursed amount, okay, and divided column, if I come in here, so I will divide this, I'll delete this, okay. So I have this particular part, and yeah, so this is asking me the payment methods, or I can simply use the payment to work with. Yeah, so similarly, what I'll do is I will get the data for Excel and for the next part, which is my India's loan. And if I take it up from here, I can get it, the loan thing in here, and I have the loan amount is ready here. I do not need the region, country code, country, borrower, guarantee type, and guarantor as usual. And I will simply don't want the non-pool type again. Repeat status, I definitely need it. Interest rate, I will take it as in the whole number similarly. And the currency of commitment, I do not need it all again. Budget ID, budget name, I need it. Now the principal amount, I will again divide it up by 1000. And once I have here, it's already been changed into the whole number. And the cancel amount, I first of all will divide up by 1000. And then I will round up into rounding down, and I can get in the whole number, as well as I do not need the undisbursed amount. The disbursed amount, I can take it up into basically a division of 100, of 1000 specifically. And once I'm doing it, I'll get it here. And similarly, I can see that there are certain decimal points are in here. So what I'll do is I will rounding up down into this, and I can get it into whole number. Similarly, the repeat to IBRD, and once it is in IBRD, I will again divide it up by 1000, and I will rounding up down, and similarly I will check whether it's a whole number or not, is there. So furthermore, I will delete all these columns present in here. So I will just remove these columns. Once I'm here, my columns are done. So I will use the loan amount. So I will go for the next source, which is basically my payment stream method. Again, it will show me the same part, and this time it will be unique. The project name is there, I definitely need it. The borrower is a constant factor, so I do not need it this at all, the borrower. Loan type, definitely I needed it. Loan status is I needed it. Interest rate, I can see there are only three part in here, but I have no such issues, because interest rate is definitely an important factor. Country from which is the loan been taken from is Egypt, and I'll take this as a whole. Original principal amount, I will again make it short into divide it by 1000, and I can get it in here. And same, the cancelled amount, I will take this cancelled amount as same into division of 1000. And then what I'll do is I will rounding it up down, so it gives me the perfect whole number. On disbursed amount, I will simply divide it by 100, and similarly I will round it up down, and once it does, it gives me the whole amount. Disbursed amount, I will take it up 1000 again, and once I do it, it's giving me this particular part, and I will rounding up down to so that it gives me this particular sector. And I have principal amount, cancel disbursed amount, and in this particular factor I will use the repaid to IBRD because of it is necessary, so whether it has been repaid or not. So I will take it up and use the 1000 and I will round it up down to give me the particular lookout. Now I will delete all these particular columns from here and I will remove these columns to give me particular way lookout, and I will check this thing as in the money stream to the India for it. And my last source, which is basically my the total loan is available, total loan has been taken. I will take it up in here and I can simply write total loans for India. So total loans that has been taken from taken by India. So I will simply take this again, and in this time now I will take the date time. So I will add a new step again. Loan I required it, region, country code, and the controller and the guarantor I definitely not needed at all. So I'll remove these columns. So I have fully repaid is showing me in here, and some are cancelled. So I will stick groceries in here. Interest rate I'll definitely make a roundup again, and the currency of commitment I will delete it. Project ID I will delete it. Project name definitely I needed it. I will take that principal amount and I will divide it by 1000. So once it's been done, I will take the cancelled amount as well and I will divide it by 1000. So once it has been done, I will take up into the rounding section, and once it does, I can get the values done in here. The undisbursed amount I do not need it at all, and likewise I the disbursed amount I will divide it by 1000 again, and once I am dividing it by 1000, I can get it that the rounding function should be like this. And the repaid to IBRD, I will take 1000 again here, and I will rounding it down to this particular part. Now, a part of all this thing, the due to IBRD and all, I will simply remove these columns. And when I remove these columns, I have a particular data set ready. Notice, loan I have already in here, and total loans are already been done. So I will take as the status or the status of the loan to be paid. So I'll simply rename it, and as usual I will close and apply, and the model definitely gets loaded inside the Power Query X Velocity Power BI X Velocity engine, and from there we will have to build the relationships like it is in here. Now once I'm in here, you can see that the money part is completely separate, and the loan part and the payment part is all together. Now it is because of the data I have this particular part, this particular section. For reasons of this, I have to get to like this in this fashion. But as you know that this particular part is basically the this particular part is basically our what we can say, this is the lookup table, this is the lookup table, and this is the data table. So the money or the data is flowing from one to many, and the direction is showing as such. And because of that, this particular part is where all the key functionality has been done, and this is where all the data store has been done. Now you can see that the data is all filtered down to the investment part of the table. As well as I want to point out that if I add a single row in here, it will convert into column in investment, and if I add a single column in here, it will add up a row in here. So likewise, now the money is the part which I want to connect with the end of period. But notice, it will show me this particular functionality because it is getting merged with the project name and the end of period. So I will take only single type of filter between filters of the money, and it will give me this particular functionality, which is many to many. So this is my financial model, and likewise I will have the data model ready in here, which I will start using it into my next particular video. Thank you for being in here, and I wish you a very good day, and I look forward to see you once again in my next video. Till then, bye.